White Hart Lane. We've just been plunged into darkness here, but White Hart Lane, very much the place to be on this Saturday night out in London. Normally the fans are thrilled by Gary Lineker's scoring excellence. Last season this stage belonged to Gazza. Tonight it's all about a couple of fighting men. Chris Eubank from Brighton, Michael Watson from nearby Islington. That's very much Arsenal territory. Eubank Watson 2 then coming up live to decide the WBO World Super Middleweight Championship. Hello, a very good evening to you all. This ringside seat, which cost you £150, we're bringing you right to the heart of the action here. The two fighters are due out from their dressing rooms on the other side of the pitch very shortly. I have to tell you, this isn't the first time we've come to White Hart Lane for a big fight. We were here back in October 1987. Frank Bruno ended Joe Bugner's career. Frank just been given the all clear to box on, dominated the contest, and Big Joe finally keeled over in the eighth. October 87, the last time we saw him in the ring. Better give you a weather check. It's a bit unusual, I know, in boxing, but we are outdoors. Cool and dry here, and a breeze in the air. Now, I have to tell you, the reason we're all here for Watson Eubank 2 is that last time they met live on ITV, millions of you watching, and a lot of experts as well, a lot of very shrewd boxing judges, were absolutely convinced you'd seen a miscarriage of justice.
Chris Eubank was out on his feet in that 10th round. He admits he's never been more vulnerable in his whole career. But Michael Watson couldn't knock him over, so the judges decided the outcome. Eubank got the verdict because of his early domination, and that stirred up a right old rumpus. Michael Watson looked shell-shocked. He was convinced he was world champion. There's been a distinct lack of mutual respect in the build-up to Eubank Watson 2.
You make me thick. You're pitiful. You lost the fight, right? I mean, that's the up and all of it.
You're kidding yourself.
You think so?
Yes, I know.
Let me explain something to you, okay? Before the fight, I said I wouldn't begrudge you the win. You've begrudged me the win. I won the fight. Accept that and stop whinging like a child. Let me just say, right, you're going on like you're some kind of big shot. If I was to get up and walk out of this room now, you'd be left starving, so
Aren't these quiet people who are the big shot now? Who's carrying on like a big shot?
Meanwhile,
big
back
shot,
to the 21st,
I'm making a statement. If
thank
I was to get up and walk out of this room, you're talking like you're demanding something. Oh, you like me? Keep quiet. You want to keep me quiet?
You want to keep me quiet? The 21st of September is the time.
Calm down.
Right, well, here we are at Tottenham.
There's no coming, Dan. This guy's an idiot, man.
I'm very pleased
you're
to be involved in this fight.
You're a complete and utter idiot. That's what you are.
Thank you.
I'm done with this press conference, man.
Thank you.
Right. Let me go, because I'm just going to get up and wet the gears.
No,
really?
No, no.
Really?
Robin, take me out, man.
Bye-bye, Chris.
I'm going to get Chris Eubank out, become champion, and put boxing back on the map, because the sport has to be resurrected. You know, he has pushed boxing down to the gutter. When you've got the likes of the greats, Marvin Hagler, Sugar Ray Leonard, that's put boxing on the map. And you have this man who's totally torn boxing apart. You know, he really, really makes me feel bad.
I have a lot of contempt for this man, for his frame of mind. His point of view is weak. This is what I see and detect from his personality. And so I have contempt for him.
I won the last fight, I know that. But getting Chris Eubank out of the system, beating Chris Eubank is my first priority. Becoming world champion is a second move.
I don't like him, I don't dislike him. He's not even there. I don't regard him as anything. No message for him. Who is he? I don't know who this man is. He's an obstacle of which is going to be in front of me on the 21st of September. And he's an obstacle of which I must pass. Other than that, he doesn't exist.
Yes, he does. Michael Watson is all set to go. This one is for real. No excuses at all about the wait. The fighters will be out in a couple of minutes. Rejoin us for that. Welcome back to World Championship Boxing, coming to you live from White Hart Lane. They're fighting for a vacant title tonight, the vacant world super middleweight title. That's the 12 stone as opposed to the 11-6 they had to fight for last time. Super atmosphere building up here at White Hart Lane, and the first person we're going to see into the ring is going to be Michael Watson. not the challenger, of course. The title is vacant, although Chris Eubank beat him last time. That was at the middleweight limit, and they have now moved up to a 12-stone limit that will probably suit them both much more. And here they come. Here comes Michael Watson. And what a reception he is getting. An out-and-out Arsenal fan. You won't have read so much about Michael Watson as you have seen about Chris Eubank. A very, very big night this one, though, for Watson, led out by Jimmy Tibbs, who really has taken over his training completely for this one. Is Michael Watson going to be a nearly man once again tonight? He was absolutely convinced he won the fight last time round. I have to say I agreed with him. But it was a fight that split boxing opinion right down the middle. And that's why this immediate rematch is taking place here. Let's hear the applause for Michael Watson. Watson will have brought a lot of support from just down the road from Islington in North London. You see the Gunners badge on the back. Arsenal had a pretty good day today. Is that going to be continued by one of their biggest fans, Michael Watson? Well, Jim Watt has joined me here at ringside. Jim, of course, we're going to hear your comments on the fight with Reggie Gutteridge. And I know last time you thought Watson had got the verdict. Do you think he's going to get it again?
Well, I think that depends. I don't think Eubank has shown in any of his world title defences. I think he still has so much more to show. I think Michael Watson did everything he could possibly do last time. I thought he won the fight. But I feel Eubank, probably the result has woken Eubank up, and I think he can do so much better. I don't think Watson can do better. So I think Eubank has the edge.
Well, simply the best is Chris Eubank's anthem. Michael Watson says he's simply a pest, and that he's going to do boxing a favour by getting rid of him tonight. I have to go along with what Jim was hinting at there. I think the superior weight will suit Chris Eubank, and here he comes. It's a typical reception for Eubank, and that will just G him up even more. He says those close to him don't dislike him. It's only an image that's been portrayed in the press, but he is done very well on it so far, and he said he's going to be around a while yet. Chris Eubank unbeaten, of course, but moving up a weight here today. Last time he really had to starve to make the weight. Let's watch his entry now. He normally vaults over the ropes, does Chris? Eubank stage, and he's got a lot of people very interested in the fight game. He's cleared that hurdle. Will he be able to clear Michael Watson? I'm saying how he really had to work to make the weight. He had to lose something over a stone and a half, did Eubank? And he said even his eyeballs were dry before the last fight. What an atmosphere building up here for Watson Eubank 2. I'm waiting just alongside me to take you through the big fight. Jim Watt, of course, and first of all, Reggie Gutteridge. Reggie, it's all yours.
Well, what an entrance there, Jimmy. I mean, the way this fellow really gives you a big
and
show, doesn't he?
Ladies and gentlemen, promoted by Matchroom and sponsored by the Daily Mirror and the Sunday Mirror, we are proud to present the main attraction of the evening. A super middleweight contest at 12 stone over 12 rounds, each of 3 minutes duration, for the vacant WBO Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Your judges for the contest are Dave Paris of London, England, Frank Brunet of New Jersey, Nelson Vasquez Santiago of Puerto Rico. Your WBO supervisor is Ed Levine of Miami in Florida, and your British Boxing Board of Control sterling charge is Bill Shearing. Your referee for the contest is Roy Francis of Kent, and your timekeeper, Ray Rice of Morton. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting and introducing to you in the red corner with the red and white shorts, with 26 wins from 30 contests, 22 inside the distance, the current Commonwealth middleweight champion from Islington in London, Michael Hartstein! And his opponent in the red corner with the blue shorts, unbeaten in 28 contests, 17 inside the distance, Brighton's former WBO middleweight champion of the world, Chris Eubank! Ladies and gentlemen, at the weigh-in at 10 o'clock today at the Grosvenor House Hotel, Michael Watson scaled 11 stone 12 pounds, Chris Eubank 11 stone 13 pounds. I thank you.
Well, it would seem to me that this weight change, as Jim Rohn sort of said, moved up from middleweight to super middleweight, and just being interrupted there by a police message to get people standing on their seats. Will make a big difference, and, the bookmakers here on course, as it were, upstairs here at Tottenham, they make it 2-1 on the Eubank, and they were telling me that most of the money there has, in fact, come for Eubank. So now, this fight last time didn't really come to light, really, to fire until about the fifth or sixth round. But this time, I think we're going to get it early on. This extra weight suits both fighters. I would think their natural middleweight days are over. They're now up in this division, the division between middleweight and light heavyweight. So the man they love to hate, and it's now already the chance of Watson, which is the first time that an Arsenal supporter carrying the Gunners on his dressing gown tonight, probably ever been cheered like that on the Spurs ground. Good counter-punching there with Eubank, Jim. We waited for Watson to come and he let a handy-looking flurry go there.
Yeah, Eubank put punches together well, which was one of the faults we found with him. He doesn't put punches together often enough. He had single shots, but that was a good bust. And already, Reg, this looks like being a far better meeting than the first one. Obviously, they're both far stronger and far sharper at this weight. You can see that already.
I mean, there is genuine dislike here and contempt, as you heard, on the part of Eubank. And, the Mr. Nice Guy obviously becomes Watson in this one. And, Eubank, to be fair, says he's been misunderstood, and because he wants to make a statement, why should he be termed arrogant? Oh, this good start, Jim. There's some good solid punching coming here. What a difference that makes going up a division.
Well, Watson started the previous meeting very calmly, as though he was worried about the 12 rounds. He didn't get going in the early rounds, which for me left it close enough for him to lose the fight, although I felt he didn't. He should have won. But he's far sharper here in the early rounds, and Eubank has had to respond in the same manner.
Good pace by Watson in the opening round as well. He claims that he's got a new lease of life since he got Jimmy Tibbs back, and he's had him as a cut man, but now he's got him as his full trainer, and he says, "I've really changed completely at the gymnasium for this fight." Good opening round. And the countdown clock inside the last half minute then, and remember, of course, scheduled for 12 rounds of championship fight. and I have to emphasize, if one boxer goes down three times in the same round, it's automatically over. That is how Nigel Benn won two WBO championships, by having three knockdowns in one round. Roy Francis, the referee from London, really. First championship fight by Roy Francis, but he doesn't vote. And the great strut back to the corner there. Almost bumping into the sponsor's round girl. Ronnie Davis, former boxer, supervises is a better word, turns up and helps Eubank. I don't know whether that's contempt or not, Jim. Oh yes, no, he is going to sit down now. Let's have a look now and replay of that, Jim.
Well, Watson obviously intends to keep Eubank under pressure as much as he possibly can. Eubank really had a good burst of punches in the early part of the round, but Watson really forced the pace for most of the opening round. A lot of punches were blocked and slipped, but a good action-packed first round.
Well, Jim, I can tip you up. I just put my head over the Puerto Rican judge's shoulders there. He went for Eubank in that round. Now, it's such a subjective game, really, scoring the boxing, and, maybe the viewers, or some of you anyway, might like to get your paper out and just score yourselves as you go along there. 10 points per round and proportionate to the loser. 10.9 is an average. Oh, it's a much better fight, Jim.
Eubank is the one with the power, Reg. He's shown that once again. He really is far stronger than Watson. Watson, I think, although he has to be aggressive, he's going to have to tighten up a little bit. He's just a little bit too cavalier.
See, he's been in a melting pot before, Watson. A great fight with Mike McCallum, the world champion, and was beaten in 11th.
See, Watson's really got himself fired up, but he doesn't want to be too fired up. There's a long time to go. Eubank is very, very strong. Watson is putting full power into these punches when Eubank's chin is tucked so tightly in defence. So he's not going to knock him out with these punches. He should cut down on the power and just look for volume in the early rounds.
Let's get back to that good left hand jabbing, I think, for Watson too, to try and keep him at bay, but he's not trying to do that. He wants to, let's have a macho battle by the look of it. And that might go right into Eubank's hands, that one, if he wants to stand and trade, and they are there.
Eubank is throwing some good quality punches back, Reg. Watson, for me, is just a little bit too loose in this round. He's trying to bust his way through Eubank's defence instead of opening it up. He's actually doing in reverse what Nigel Benn was trying to do with him.
Well, Jim, if this is going to keep up, like, it's not going to be another easy contest to score, I don't think. Certainly the power, definitely, is coming from Eubank, and the strength of punch does influence judges, of course.
Well, I think Watson realises that Eubank does not like working under pressure. He likes to dictate the pace, he likes to walk around, have a pose, a look, and do things at his own pace. I think that Watson's plan is to dictate the pace, but it is one tremendous pace he's setting.
Well, there's a real rate of punch going in there, but countdown then for the end of the second. Oh, can they keep it up? Back then for the third round WBO Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Somebody called it the beauty and the boast. But this is real professional, good quality stuff.
match. I think Eubank is putting a lot more thought into his boxing than Watson is. He's the one under pressure, but he's picking his shots well. His defence is sound. Watson is just a little bit too reckless for my liking.
It's this great desire, you see, Jim. This, all that nurtured hate that he's had before the fight. Watson, it doesn't really suit his temperament or his style, does it?
See, one of the reasons that Watson beat Nigel Benn was because Benn wasted so much power hitting arms in the top of the head, and he's doing the same thing tonight. Okay, he's really firing on all cylinders, he's driving the pace, but if you're going to throw full power into punches, they have to count. And Watson's putting full power into punches that have been blocked. He's going to run out of steam, and Eubank's still going to be there.
Oh, as close as we are to him, Jim, I tell you, you were almost riding those. I mean, they're good short shots of Eubank there, weren't they?
Yeah, well, the quality of punching is coming from Eubank. He's setting himself well. Concentration good, and see, there's Watson lunging now. This is not the Michael Watson. I feel a little bit sorry for Watson. Each time he's fought for a world title, he has an opponent that doesn't suit his style. He likes the counter punch. Like the other fellow lead off, both Mike McCallum and Eubank have been the opposite kind of fighter.
Well, Alan, that's a long way to go yet. It's... minute to go in the third.
Watson's just not getting to him in this round, they said.
Connected at the same time there, Jim.
They both landed the shots, and Eubank was the one who dipped slightly just to cushion the next one coming, so he obviously felt the power of that one.
Such a difficult man to fight though, Eubank. His style is so unusual, and he's a very strong guy. Absorbs a punch very well.
I don't think Eubank likes this constant action, Reg. Maybe that is what Watson's banking on. Just keeping a pace like this, knowing that Eubank, who says he doesn't really like the fight game, maybe hopes he maybe can't cope with it, but he's coping with it well at the moment.
Well, I tell you what, Jim, here at ringside we're needing a breather at the end of these rounds. I'm sure these boys certainly need it, although it's certainly a cool evening. It's good for him, for them anyway. Jim, there it is again in replay. There it's
Watson, as usual, just driving forward, forcing the pace. Eubank, thinking about defence, thinking about the 12 rounds. His own counters were very accurate, a great deal in that round, particularly the first couple of minutes.
I like the way that Eubank put it to me today. He says, this fellow Watson, strictly an obstacle of which I must get past in order to enhance my standard of living. He rarely says one word when 10 will do.
10 seconds.
Jimmy Tibbs then working there in Watson's corner. Well, there's been some memorable fights here over the years. As a matter of fact, I was fortunate enough to see those, and this might live up to it. So we're going right back to Mills and Harvey and Woodcock and London. Just shows you, Jim, how they were really weight weak and last time. I'm surprised how hard they must have worked, because they both weighed 11 stone 6. And now we've got Eubank in 11 13 and Watson at 11 12. In fact, they both have weighed that as high as that before in ordinary preliminary contests. That surprises me, that can go up and down like that.
Well, right from the first bell, they both look like different athletes altogether. Now, Watson has slightly dropped the pace here, and it'll be very noticeable, and Eubank will certainly be the first one to notice that. He's being allowed to pick him with some jabs now. See, that's the danger in starting at such a pace. The other fellow really feels if he can't maintain that pace. Good shot from Watson.
See, Eubank's as good at that knowing how to take a breather every so often, Jim, doesn't he? He walks away from them, just buys his time.
Well, Watson's got through with a couple of solid shots in this round. He still has that kind of careless attitude. He doesn't care what's coming back as long as his are getting home. Dangerous tactics in a 12-rounder.
Referee Roy Francis can afford to keep well away from them like this. So it's a good start for his first world championship. He's judged a few for the WBC. That's because the Boxing Board of Control is now affiliated to the WBO. And this is the first time a British referee's handled one of their fights.
Eubank looks, blood.
Yeah, it's Eubank over the left eye.
Yep.
Remember seeing him cut in a fight before, Jim? Eubank?
Yeah, I think he was cut. Actually, I think he was cut in the Watson fight.
Was he?
Yeah, but it was right at the end of the fight, if I remember. I remember him saying he was cut before. I remember seeing him cut.
See, now he slowed the pace down again, Eubank, there, isn't he, by backing off.
Yeah, well, this is what he is good at, and this is all part of his tactics. He doesn't like working at this pace.
What a fight. Round five, and Watson had a good round in the fourth. And the future opponent, presumably for the winner, is Nigel Benn. Just alongside us here somewhere, and it sounded to me as though he was rooting for Watson. Good fight, Jim. I'm enjoying this far more than the last one, which everybody thought was a stormer, but you and I thought it took too long to catch fire, didn't we?
Yeah, I don't think the previous fight lived up to what everybody expected, but this one has surpassed that, I would say. But Eubank again trying to get some daylight between both boxers. He wants to slow the pace down, slow the work rate down. But Watson, obviously, he's really pumped up in the corner. His corner man's pumping him up even more just to keep this pace going. They know Eubank doesn't like it.
Each other again there with punch. They're really standing there toe to toe. I don't need the sides of this ring the way they're fighting now. It's could have this one in a telephone booth. I haven't counted heads yet, but the crowd, they've got a good walk up to the gate at the finish. And I would say at around 18,000 here, probably a little less than promoter Barry Hearn wanted, but still a very good turnout. And at high prices too. Still, they can manage to come up with some money here because they also found the sponsorship. The Sunday Mirror and Daily Mirror. And certainly Eubank has been getting a lot of ink in the last two or three weeks about this fight. He's trying to get on top again now, Watson. Jim, I thought maybe he might have won the last two rounds. Certainly Eubank won the first two, so again there's not much in this.
Yeah, well, Watson's in trouble in the first half minute of the round, but once the pace slows that little bit, he's a little bit more effective than Eubank. See, Eubank again, he's always first to back off. He wants to slow the pace. This type of fight doesn't suit him, and no signs of Watson tiring. Obviously the weight suits both of them.
Obviously I emphasise to you, of course, our opinion must be unofficial. It's very subjective, as I said, to try and score boxing at times. But we'll leave that again to the three. Well, they're more experienced judges, I think, than they were on the first one as well. Oh, I love that stare at the end there. I mean, it's not as temptuous. So here's Gary Newbon with Nigel Benn.
Nigel, why are you yelling for Michael Watson?
What are you thinking about? They're both beating me, but I've got a lot of respect for Michael inside the ring and outside the ring, and no person more than me would like to see Michael win a title.
Well, do you think Eubank's winning at the moment, though?
No.
Why not? Why do you think Mike Watson's in front?
He's aggression, he's coming forward, he's connecting with good shots. I mean, I'm really so happy that he's actually changed his tactics and come out and being so aggressive.
Can he keep this pace up, though, Michael, do you think?
Can Eubanks last as long? Who knows? But, you know, please God, I hope he does. Nobody else would like to win a title more than Michael. Good guy.
Come on, Mike!
And there it is. We'll find out if Ducky's got the good judges before the end of this contest. Jim Watson, I think, is pretty level. Eubanks were very dominating at the start, but he hasn't been in the last couple of rounds, Jim.
Yeah, but he's still keeping his defence, he's sound, his concentration still as it always is. Watson usually takes the first minute or so to get up close. He's got a little bit closer sooner in this round. And Watson maybe not wasting quite as many punches. Good solid jab from Watson. And just a push there, just a push.
No. And Roy Francis says don't do that again and tells the timekeeper don't pick up the count and just gives the gloves a wipe. From the back of the stadium here, they might have thought that was a punch. Now, Jim, if Eubanks is a bit surprised how Watson has come back at him so strongly.
No, I think he knows what to expect. A little smack of heads there. But I'm surprised that Watson hasn't gone to the body a little bit more. I mean, he saw Eubanks tire in the previous match. There are a few signs now of him stumbling around. I'm surprised Watson maybe not thinking a little bit more of some body attack.
I had a sort of knockdown that he claimed was a slip with the Nigel Benn. I think it was also the canvas was watered a bit. Eubank, and he took his time getting up from that one. That was sort of, so what was that all about? Quite annoyed by the look of him.
A couple of good body shots there.
Oh, there's some good stuff now from Watson, and the crowd are really raising too. Refuses to move away from him, Eubank. It's contemptuous again. He's got plenty of fighter's heart, Eubank. He might have a big mouth, Jim, but he can back up a bit.
Yeah, you can't fault him, Reggie. When he's called upon, he produces the goods. A couple of his defences, hasn't been too impressive, but maybe he felt he didn't have to be to hold on to his title. When he's got to respond, he usually does it. Eubank just becoming a little bit more ragged now, Reg. He's not quite the composure he had earlier.
It looks like he's trying to pinch a rest, and he'll be glad when he hears this bell coming up. Round 7. And, and on work rate, Jim, certainly now Watson could be ahead.
Yep, Eubank really has landed some good accurate counter punches. Watson setting all the pace, throwing a lot more punches. I think we're going to end up with another one of these fights where it just depends what type of boxing you prefer. Personally, I like the way Watson's going about the job again. Really, the total commitment, the work rate. He's been a little bit careless. He's taken some punches maybe he didn't have to take. But I would have Watson in front just on the sheer commitment and the volume of the punches. Eubank is always the one looking for that little breather.
Hey, stand there.
Watson's always dying to get back in there again. He stands there, sticking to him like a barnacle at times there.
We'll have to see how long it takes Eubank to throw back here now. He didn't throw back at all, Rich.
Pretty clean fight, Jim. Roy Francis hasn't had a lot to do here, I'll say that for them.
See, this is Eubank under pressure, Rich. I want to see how he copes with this. Does he go on his bike or does he throw back some punches?
Oh, some good stuff right above us here, Watson. Landing those blows there. He tried to hide us for a second or two there.
Yeah, but he's stumbling, he's making basic mistakes and having to duck and dive to avoid the counters. He's just becoming a little bit more ragged now, and obviously the pressure and the pace has something to do with that. See, Watson's still, all these punches are good quality punches. Eubank, not quite the quality we've seen earlier. Eubank toying a little bit now.
Keep your hands up, Mick. They're shouting in the corner to Watson. But he's in the shape of his life, Watson. I mean, he really took a slight hammering with Mike McCallum, but he's not showing at all. Another good round for Watson.
Cracking round.
And he takes his time back to the school as usual there, like a long walk along the beach at Brighton, he thinks it is. But I think he won't agree with this, of course, Eubank, when he gets to the video and looks at the replays on Diamond. What were you two saying about me? He never gets too pleased about what we said about him in the past, Jim.
Well, I thought that Eubank's performance in that round, it wasn't as sharp, the punches weren't the quality punches we saw earlier. You can see here, Watson's punches, still good professional shots, right on target. Eubank pawed a little bit, some of his shots were decent shots, but I thought his standard dropped slightly in that round.
Round eight of this 12 rounds World Boxing Organization version of the super middleweight 12 stone division.
You see, I really feel by now Eubank should be trying to hurt Watson, stand his ground, use the strength we know he has and the punching power, but he's still been backed up. He hasn't really tried to stop Watson in his tracks, and I think it's high time he did that.
Punching back well now, Eubank.
I think it's time for Eubank to do that and now start coming forward if he wants to hang on or win this title.
Minute gone in the eighth. Soccer-style chance for the football fan, Watson. When Eubank was saying before the fight, Jim, that, you know, this fellow doesn't exist, I think he might just change his mind now.
Yeah, I think actually we might see a bit of mutual respect for a change at the end of this one. Eubank, he's produced a little bit better quality work in this round. He's still a little bit ragged in his movements, but he's responded well as usual. Watson's still driving forward, but Eubank just a little bit sharper.
It's a tough game at the top, Jimmy.
Yeah, this is certainly a tough one. Thankfully, Rage has lived up to his pre-fight height. This is a cracker.
It seems to me that when he throws those punches, Watson, the look on Eubanks' face, I think the surprise on his face is still there long after the pain was gone. So referee Francis there has to collect each card at the end of each round of the judges and give them to the WBO supervisor Ed Levine from Miami, and sometimes they don't know the judges and when they hand them in and how they've actually got it. And we're up, there's a man hot shot
well,
today himself, wasn't
here.
He?
How do you see the fight going so far?
Well, I think they're both working on it. It's a terrific fight, very exciting. I think Watson looks on top at the moment. Chris Eubank looks a little bit tired, but I'm no expert.
Who do you want to win?
I don't mind. I've just come for... I love the big fights. I'm not stupid enough to tell you what to do.
Listen, you've had a good day, by the way. Well done. 4 goals today.
Yeah, it was a great day. It was nice to win. First time I've ever scored for the club.
Well done.
Out for the 9th round.
Well, I think it's time Eubank should be trying to dominate around Reg. He's been pushed around the ring right from the first bell. Even the rounds he was winning, he was being pushed back to do it. I think he's going to have to stand his ground and see if he can discourage this man. Personally, I don't think he can. Watson's really fired up.
And I wonder what the judges, when they fought before, I said I couldn't read how the American judges would view this, but we have got an English judge, Dave Paris, and then a New Jersey judge, Frank Brunette, who's experienced, and Nelson Vasquez of Puerto Rico, is sitting just alongside us here.
Strong.
Yeah, but Watson still hasn't cut down that punch rate. He's kept that going the whole time.
Well, full credit to Jimmy Tibbs. He's got him in tremendous shape. Always say it's easier to cope with a pace if you're the one setting the pace. And I think Eubank must be feeling this because he is under the pressure. He's been forced to work every second.
That's the first sort of untidy bit we've seen there, was lolling on the ropes and allowing him to punch and have to be parted.
Watson just seems to disregard the punches that Eubank lands on him. Just totally fired up.
Well, when he made the statement that beating Eubank meant more to him than winning the actual world title, it was just getting rid of Eubank that he was more concerned about than winning the championship. But when he can put that belt around him at the end of this, if he keeps this up.
Eubank's been pretty accurate, Reg, the last minute or so with these counters. He doesn't look as effective as Watson, but he's slipping these punches and pinning back some nice little counters.
Yeah, watch when he throws that uppercut sometimes, Eubank. That's right through the middle of Watson's guard. There it is, no miss with that one. Nearly put the lights out.
See, I think the difference, when Watson misses with a shot, he can still come back with 3 or 4 more. When Eubank misses, he goes off balance. Then he has to duck and dive. See, then he throws a punch, it doesn't land, and he's lost his coordination.
Nosebleed by Watson, but I think he can cope with that all right. So that they fly in the ring these seconds. The moment that bell goes, and they're just using a swab, I think, the other way there. And Freddie King, the cut man, ex-boxer in Eubank's corner, taking care of that nick around the eye, which surprised me really, hasn't worsened since early on. That's the adrenaline that's they can use it. The border control allow as a coagulant, it's the only thing they allow, and there's an inspector from the board in the corner to make sure that nothing else is used. That's just gargles, by the way, they don't normally swallow that stuff, and water only. Oh, once upon a time they even used to shower champagne over them in the corners, but that's died out, I'm pleased to say. Round 10. How have you got it now, Jim?
Well, I haven't found one round easy to score, Reg. Every round of the fight so far has been so close. Nobody has dominated at all. I have Watson in front at the moment for his total commitment and his work rate. But I thought Eubank was very accurate with his counter punches in the ninth round. So Watson, I think, wants to find some strength just to get the pace back up where it was. If the pace drops slightly, then Eubank is going to be allowed to become effective. But with the sensible boxing, the smart moves and the counter punching.
Stop pushing him down there. He's on to that, Francis. Oh, what a good long right hand there. He planted that one. He travelled a long way, but Eubank got the message.
This is a truly great fight, Reg. This fight is everything. A good shot from Watson. Again, Eubank's chin stands well.
Okay, he's slow to recover when he missed with a punch there. Eubank stood still for just a second and he got nailed.
That's where Eubank is so vulnerable. If he misses with a punch, he goes all off balance. He can't come back with the other punch. Watson, he can put punches together smoothly. Really climbing in top here, Reg. See, when Eubanks misses, look where he goes.
Yes, he really flounders.
He's not an attacking boxer at all. Eubanks looking over his shoulder, look at him. It looks as though he's feeling a little bit sorry for himself here, Reg.
Eyes swelling up too on the left there, Eubanks. I think he's genuinely surprised at the rate that Watson has come at him. He was hoping he'd punch himself out with Watson, but he hasn't done so far. What a good contest, though, eh?
Yeah, generally, every big fight has a round that just seems to turn things. This could be that round, because they're both really feeling so tired and having to force it on.
If you recall, during the last fight, the 10th round was a bad one for Eubank.
The difference I see, Reg, when they both land simultaneously, Watson just carries on to the next punch, but Eubank is the one who's looking to slip the punch, get things defensively. Watson is just total attack.
Have to pull Eubank back to the corner. He's just strolling there. He's looking a little bit despondent. He'll probably deny that later. What were you saying? How do you know I was despondent? But he gives that impression, doesn't he? I'm watching this again.
See, at the end of a flurry, Watson is the one who wants to get right back down to work, whereas Chris Eubank wants to go for a little walk to gather his breath again.
See from the overhead camera there. Terrific pace, no doubt about it. Not all the punches are going through. You can't when you throw them at that speed. So they pinch in every second they can to patch up those minor injuries, really, by boxing standards. 11th round. Now, are we going to going to get another controversial decision. At this point, Jim, I'll be surprised. I've certainly got Watson ahead now.
Yeah, but Reg, every round has been so close, so we're now looking... I mean, nobody has dominated really any of the rounds, but Eubank has started the last couple of rounds as though he wants to try and gain control, but he gives up too quickly. He just can't seem to cope with Watson's commitment, so he has to go on the defensive again. But he's boxing well on the defensive.
Tiredness obviously showing in there, Jim. They're missing a bit.
Yeah, Eubank has become ragged from about the seventh round, but I think a lot of that has just been the pace. And as I say, he doesn't like attacking when he's forced to come up forward a little bit and miss with a punch. He really is vulnerable.
Oh, what toe-to-toe stuff this is. It's almost gladiatorial, this, isn't it?
A good shot from Eubank, and again he finds the strength to pile it on. Watson shaking his head. Watson wants to tighten up. This is the first time Watson wants to think about defence.
Referee had to get in there, and he got in well too.
Well, Red, Eubank has found the strength when it was needed. Watson should be tightening up here, Red.
Nearly hit the referee accidentally with that one. The ropes are far too slack. What a round, the 11th round. One to go after this.
Reg, we can't fault Eubank's desire, but he seems to have used up an awful lot in that round. I wonder, could that be a do or die effort? He used up a lot of steam with those attacks. Watson again coming back. I mean, this must demoralise Eubank. He's produced his best one, and then he's on the receiving end again, and in trouble!
There it is. Can he have him over? He's got plenty of guts, Eubank. He's standing there taking the best one. Oh, he's got him down now. That's the first clean knockdown he's had in his career. Now, is he going to give him a mandatory 8 count? I thought he would have that under WBO. I'm surprised at that. Oh. He's walked in and he's now Watson. Stay down. The trainer's calling out to Watson. Take the 8 count. And the bells, there was no actual count. We couldn't hear whether the timekeeper was taking it up or not. Absolutely sensational 11th round. I was surprised you didn't take up the count there though, Jim, didn't you? I would have thought WBO was a mandatory 8.
Yeah, just a complete mix-up, I think, but the bell saved the second count, because he was on his feet when the bell rang, so the referee doesn't really have to count on. But what action in that round?
Oh.
Watson, just a little bit careless. If Eubank over, there was a tremendous shot that shook Eubank right down to his toes, but maybe a little bit careless. Eubank threw everything into the one shot, bang, right up through the middle. That was a beautiful shot.
Well, I tell you, they're like an army. They've got to sort of rejuvenate their spirit for the last round.
I would say Eubank looks slightly stronger as they sit in their stools here. Can Watson recover from that punch?
The crowd now, absolutely atmosphere, electric atmosphere. Incredible. He's forcing them to shake hands, but he looks rocky on the legs there, Watson.
Watson hasn't recovered, Reg. Watson hasn't recovered, his legs don't look right.
Under 3 minutes to go, can he hang on now? What a cliffhanger. He's going to dive in and he stopped it in the last round. Eubank has brought it out from nowhere. And there's an argument going on over there in Watson's corner. Saying to the referee, what for? It was the last round, he wanted to give him a chance, but no. The ring's invaded now, we're having an absolute... Well, what can I say? It's a jamboree in there now. I don't know how they all get in with the security around the ringside. What a finish to a fight.
Well, Reg, as they sat in the corner, Eubank looked the stronger. Watson didn't look as though he'd recovered. When he stood up, you could see his legs were unsteady. It wasn't the damage that Eubank inflicted in the last round, then the the half minute or so it lasted, it was the damage was done in the previous round. That one shot up through the middle finished the job. The bell saved Watson, but he couldn't recover. He's just a spent force.
Oh, I don't know how we can take the shock of what you've done. I hope you feel the same at home as we do here. I mean, it's the atmosphere is generating, and I think the Puerto Rican judge had Watson 1 point ahead.
Reg, you can't argue with the result this time because Eubank come off the floor, produced the goods in the last round. Once again, he did pretty much the same as he did against Nigel Benn. He did everything that could be asked of him. He was a half fight all the way through, and he was the man who finished in top. Full credit to Eubank this time.
Oh, you're absolutely right. He did all that was asked of him. The guy who's trying to get a championship back as a new challenger in the new in a higher weight division, and it looked all over by the shouting a couple of times for him, but when it mattered he came and did it. I never argue with a referee who stopped a contest. I always prefer it too early than too late.
Chris, can you talk to ITV? An incredible finish. Finish from your point of view.
I knew from round six this man was too strong for me, but I knew that my training, my running, my brother Simon took me running for 6 weeks, and I knew that I could go the distance, and I knew he would tire with this pace. He kept up a phenomenal pace. When I caught him, I knew that was it. I didn't know whether he would revive in between the round. He didn't, and I got him. Let me thank my brother Simon for taking me running. Let me thank my wife Karen for putting up with me this last 6 weeks. And let me thank the people, the newspaper, and the people for voting me Boxer of the Year. And let me thank the Men's Association of Great Britain for awarding me the... To award me the best man award in Britain. I'm sorry I can't talk very clearly, but he hit me a good couple of shots. Michael Watson is a very good fighter, very underestimated. He was very, very strong. I want him tested. I want him tested to see whether he has anything in his blood, because he was so strong.
See? Now, you've just been knocked down. It looked as if the fight was going to be over.
Yeah.
But you got up.
I've got a chin. What's all these people here? What's all these people? Yeah, I kept it up. God gave me the strength. I thank God for the victory. He gave me the strength. And I thank goodness.
Chris, are you saying, what were you saying about drugs there? I kept hearing you say something.
No, I said, I want his urine tested, because no one is that strong. No one can be that strong.
Are you suggesting that, don't concern yourself with that, there's a bit of trouble outside the ring which we didn't bother ourselves with. Are you suggesting he was on something there, Chris? Chris, can I keep your attention a minute? We've lost Chris Eubank because there are some fights going on and he wants some protection. So I'm going to hand you back to Jim Rosenthal in just a moment. Absolute chaos in the ring.
Well, it's
here.
Very sad what's going on in the ring behind me here. We've had a great fight before this. Sadly, things are broken down here a bit. We're going to take a break now. We'll be back within a couple of minutes. Welcome back to ringside. Things seem to have calmed down a bit in the ring behind me, I'm glad to say. I'm hearing that the judges going into that last round, in fact, had Michael Watson ahead on all three cards. So, Jim, what that meant that Eubank had to knock him out to win, and he did just that.
That's exactly what he did. A tremendous performance for Eubank. I thought, really, it was all over for him in the 11th round. He came back with a tremendous punch, and that was the punch that finished the fight. What he did in the 12th round was just icing on the cake. Watson didn't recover. He'd used up so much steam in the first 11 rounds that he just couldn't recover in the minute in between rounds.
What do you make of the suggestions from Chris Eubank there? Have you made in the heat of the moment that Watson might have been on some sort of stimulant to make him so strong?
Well, Eubank always says something I wish he hadn't said, and that's that tonight. He said he's done it again. A tremendous battle. Everybody in the country must be really loving the sport of boxing, the excitement in the game, and he comes away with a remark like that. I just wish he hadn't said it. A terrible, stupid thing to say.
Okay, We're just seeing that Watson, in fact, has collapsed in his corner, and that is really sad news. Obviously, it's very, very difficult from us here at ringside to say what the problem is with Michael Watson. And of course, the British Boxing Board of Control medical people will be in there very quickly. And let's hope he is given full and ample time to recover from that. There are still, as Chris Eubank looks along anxiously, a lot of ugly scenes here at ringside. And that's a shame, because here tonight, Jim, we have had a fight really to remember for a very long time.
Yeah, well, the WBO as an organisation was in for some stick, but that fight will go a long way to maybe raising their image. That was a tremendous battle, everything, skill, courage, bravery, a tremendous pace from start to finish, and such a convincing ending, and a knockout in the last round. The fight had everything.
That's right. There's another big fight coming up on ITV on Monday week. Lennox Lewis against Glenn McCrory, British and European heavyweight title. That'll be live here on ITV on Monday week. A very big fight like that. Well, Chris Eubank, he's had a very, very busy year, hasn't he? You would think Jimmy will take a few months off now and perhaps come strong for Nigel Benn in the new year.
Yeah, I think after a fight like that, they'll have to rest Eubank. He's been a busy champion. He's produced the goods tonight. He really produced everything tonight. He wants a long holiday, a rest, and then get back into the gym nice and fresh, because with Nigel Benn, it's going to be another hard one.
And just finally about Michael Watson, is he going to be one of those fighters that we'll remember in future years as a nearly man?
Yeah, well, that's the problem. Is one of his first world title challenge against Mike McCallum, a dramatic ending. He took an awful lot of punishment. We wondered, could he recover from that? The same thoughts are in my mind now. He's still he's lying there, totally exhausted. Can he recover from that? I wouldn't think so.
Jim Watt, thank you very much indeed. It's been an unbelievably dramatic night here at White Hart Lane. For most of the fight, it looked as though Michael Watson was going to be the new champion of the world. Chris Eubank pulled out something very special in that last round. I hope you all enjoyed the fight. From us all at White Hart Lane, a very good night.